Hello everyone, myself Dr. Parth Goswami, and today I am going to teach you about one of the vascular disease of kidney, that is nephrosclerosis. So let's see the classification of vascular diseases of the kidney. The name vascular disease is given means in this particular disease the blood vessel of the kidney is involved, and that's why it is known by the name vascular disease of kidney. There are basically nine classification of vascular diseases of kidney. The first one is benign nephrosclerosis, then malignant nephrosclerosis, thrombotic microangiopathy, renal artery stenosis, ischemic renal disease due to atherosclerosis or atheromboli renal disease, sickle cell nephropathy, diffuse cortical necrosis, and renal infarction. If you see carefully, then all these are interconnected. Because of thrombosis and atherosclerosis, there can be clot formation in the renal vessel, and that's why the blood supply to the renal vessels can be affected, and so patient can develop necrosis and infarction as well. So you have to remember these nine category of vascular disease of kidney, that is a classification of vascular disease of kidney, among which we are going to discuss about the benign nephrosclerosis in the detail, right? All right. So let's begin with benign nephrosclerosis. Another name is nephrosclerosis simply. Here the word benign is given because it is seen in the chronic hypertension patient, right? It is seen in chronic hypertension, and here the hypertension is not malignant one, right? It is not much accelerated like that of greater than 200 systolic, right? Greater than 120 diastolic, not like that. The patient is hypertensive and chronic, and that's why the kidney changes will be seen, which is known by the name nephrosclerosis. Alright. So the nephrosclerosis term is used for the renal pathology that is associated with sclerosis of renal arteriole and small artery. The name itself suggests here there is a sclerosis of blood vessel. Particularly, it involves the small artery of the kidney. And it's strongly associated with hypertension. And you might be surprised, friends, that you know nephrosclerosis can lead to hypertension as a complication as well. So hypertension is an etiology as well as complication of nephrosclerosis. So as far as the etiology of nephrosclerosis is concerned, it could be due to hypertension, diabetes mellitus, or because of advanced age. These three are the main etiology. And if we discuss about the pathogenesis, then main pathogenesis is endothelial damage. And the endothelial damage can be seen due to hypertension mainly. And because of endothelial damage, there will be extravasation or leak of the plasma protein from the blood into the glomerulus. And so there will be hyaline material deposition as well in the basement membrane. So that is the main pathogenesis for development of, nephrosclerosis. And here the sclerosis can also be seen because of repeated trauma to the endothelium because of hypertension. Because of chronic inflammation as well, sclerosis can be seen, right? Alright. And there will be intimal thickening in this particular disorder. We will discuss it in the detail later on in the slides. So if we talk about the gross morphological appearance of kidney in the nephrosclerosis, then grossly, there will be bilateral involvement of kidney, because obviously hypertension is a systemic disease, so it involves both the kidneys. And over the kidney surface you can see a diffuse granular appearance. Over the cortex there is a diffuse granular appearance that is known by the name leather grain appearance. Now you might have questioned why such changes is seen. So that is due to a chronic hypertension, right? Chronic hypertension will lead to repeated damage to the blood vessel endothelium. So there will be repeated chronic inflammation and repeated scarring and contraction of the individual glomerulus. So it is due to the scarring and contraction of individual glomerulus, which will ultimately give granular appearance over the kidney surface, which is known by the name leather grain appearance. And because of repeated endothelial injury, repeat and chronic scarring, right? Because of sclerosis, the kidney can be contracted. So in the advanced stage, kidney can be contracted. And renal cortex is obviously thin. So this is the image showing a granular appearance over the renal cortex, which is known by the name granular cortical surface, leather grain appearance. Again, the same diagram showing, this is schematic diagram showing a small contracted kidney and scar over the renal cortex, particularly granular scar, right? That is known by the name leather grain appearance. It looks like a grain. That's why the name that's why this granular appearance given the name leather grain appearance. All right. Now, there would be two light microscopic appearance in the nephrosclerosis. The light microscopic changes morphologically in the light microscopy, two type of changes can be seen. The first one is hyaline arteriosclerosis. Now, this is simply a thickening of blood vessel by hyaline material deposition. Because of hyaline material deposition, the blood vessel will get thick, which is known by the name hyaline arteriosclerosis, and that is due to endothelial damage of the glomerulus, right? Because of endothelial damage, plasma protein will leak, and so the deposited hyaline material will thicken the blood vessel. That is known by the name hyaline arteriosclerosis. Second change is fibroelastic hyperplasia of intima. The hypertension is a systemic disease, so obviously first it will affect the endothelium of the small artery of kidney, so it will lead to endothelial damage, and because of that repeated endothelial damage, because of repeated damage there will be chronic sclerosis and fibrosis of the intima. So here the intima will get thick ultimately. So in the nephrosclerosis there could be a intimal thickening. And sometimes reduplication of elastic lamina will lead to medial hypertrophy. So that's why the name fibroelastic hyperplasia of the intima is given. It is the intimal thickening. So these two type of light microscopic changes can be seen in kidney, hyaline arteriosclerosis and fibroelastic hyperplasia of intima, intimal thickening. Alright. These both the changes will obviously narrow the lumen of the blood vessel. You can imagine that if the vessels are thickened, if the intima is thick, then lumen will get narrow. And because of that, blood supply to the kidney can be affected. And most commonly, it affects the afferent arterioles. Right? In the advanced stage, interstitium will show the chronic inflammation and fibrosis. And that's why the scar is formed, right? And that's why there is a granular appearance of kidney, which is known by the name leather grain appearance. Tubular atrophy also can be seen. And whole the glomerulus is sclerosed in the advanced stage. Alright. So this particular image demonstrates the whole morphology of the kidney involved in the nephrosclerosis. So this is the light microscopic schematic diagram of light microscopic appearance of nephrosclerosis. So here if you observe carefully, you can see that this whole blood vessel is thickened. So it is a hyaline arteriosclerosis, right? Because of hyaline material deposition, the blood vessel is thickened, which is known by the name hyaline arteriosclerosis. And the second light microscopic change is that there is an intimal thickening. So fibroelastic intimal thickening can be seen, which is also known by the name fibroelastic hyperplasia of intima, right? In the advanced stage, interstitium show the chronic inflammation and fibrosis. And sometimes whole the glomerulus can be sclerosed, right? Glomerular sclerosis also can be seen. That's why the name nephrosclerosis is given to this particular disorder, right? Here, hyaline materials are deposited, there is intimal thickening, there is a sclerosis. That's why the name nephrosclerosis is given to this particular change observed in hypertension. Alright. This is also showing sclerosis in the blood vessel and intimal thickening. This is sclerosis, right? Hyalinized thickening of blood vessel. This whole blood vessel is replaced by hyaline material deposition. You can see clearly, right? This is a very beautiful diagram showing a hyaline material deposition. So this is the case of benign nephrosclerosis. All right. Now, what could be the clinical feature and laboratory finding in nephrosclerosis? So friends, first of all, because of endothelial damage, the protein will get leak in the urine. So the patient can have mild proteinuria, and because of that, reduction of the oncotic pressure and patient can have edema. Because of endothelial damage, there could be presence of blood in the urine. So patient can have hematuria. And here there is a sclerosis of the glomerulus in the advanced stage, right? The blood vessels are also not functioning normally. So, because of sclerosis and intimal thickening, the kidney function will get hampered. And so there will be reduction of the kidney function, which is manifested as reduction in the GFR, glomerular filtration will be reduced, and there will be increased metabolic waste product because kidney is not functioning normally. So, you know, the metabolic waste product will be increased, particularly blood, urea, nitrogen and creatinine can increase, which is known by the name azotemia, which ultimately can manifest systemically, and the prognosis can be poor if it is continuously increasing, right? So that is about the clinical feature. All right, thank you very much, friends, and this is all about the nephrosclerosis. Hope it will make your fundamental clear. You know, I have also uploaded a very beautiful lecture of blood vessel changes in the hypertension. You can check the playlist and see that video of blood vessel also, right? That how hypertension affects the blood vessel. You know, in this particular disorder also the blood vessels are affected. So thank you very much. This is all about the nephrosclerosis, and see you soon in the next video. Till then, take care and bye bye.